let's do a quick review on one of the stroke assessment tools we use. It's called the LAMS score, the Los Angeles Motor Scale. This is a quick and dirty tool that we use for looking for large vessel occlusions, and it's three quick, easy steps. So the first assessment that we're going to do is a facial droop. So it's basically a yes, no. So it's either absent or it's present. So the scale is 0 or 1. 0 absent, 1 it's present. So what you're going to have them do is you have them smile, and you're looking for a droop on one of the sides of their faces. So I don't have a droop, so I'm going to pull my lip down. But when they smile, it'll kind of drop down. Or you can see it in their eyes, it'll drop down as well. And this can be confused with a condition called Bell's palsy as well, but we'll cover that another time. The second step is going to be arm drift. So what you're going to have them do, hold their arms up. And what you're looking for is to see if they can hold their arms steady, which would be a score of 0. You're looking if one side just slowly drops down, which would be a score of 1. And then the second one would be if you hold their arms up and it just drops, falls rapidly, that'd be a score of 2. So that one is just a score of 0 to 2. Last step is going to be grip strength. So this is another one that's a 0 to 2 scale. So you're going to have them put your hands together and you're going to say, you know, squeeze my hands. And you're looking to see if their grip strength is the same on each side, which would be a 0. If it's a weak grip, like they can still squeeze a little bit, but it's just not as strong as their other side, that'd be a 1. And then a 2 would be, you know, they can squeeze, say, with the left hand, but the right hand just isn't squeezing at all. That'd be a 2. So that covers the LAMS score. It's a quick and easy tool to use. Score goes from 0 to 5. 0 is less likely having a large vessel occlusion. 5, very high chance you're having a large vessel occlusion. If you have a low score, it doesn't mean you're not having a stroke. It's just the chances of a large vessel occlusion being affected is minimal. There's other tools we use like NIH scores and fast exams, but I'll cover that in the next video. And also, there's also other conditions that can affect your scores, which I talked about Bell's palsy, which affects just the face. But then we also check like blood sugar levels on people, because hypoglycemic patients can present like strokes. And also alcohol is another one. Intoxicated patients can present like strokes as well. That's why we check an alcohol level on your arrival as well.